On principle, ripoffs suck. It's genuinely a pretty bad experience to make something original and then have someone plagiarize it and often end up improving it in subtle ways or getting the real appreciation for the work. We're not about to defend plagiarism here, but there are certainly a few examples in the game industry where a title is obviously inspired by another title, but ends up fulfilling both of these criteria, improving on the games that they were inspired by or even flat out stole from. Hey guys, Arcade Cloud here. And today we're counting down our list of the 10 video game ripoffs that were better than the original. Note that we are including a few mods, as they're great mods that vastly improve or completely change the source material and are more than capable of standing on their own as games. If you're new to our channel, go ahead and subscribe and hit that bell. Give this video a thumbs up and share it with some friends.
It's free.
At number 10, we may as well start with the most obvious one, Pong. It's a ripoff of Table Tennis, which is a game that was developed just before Atari took a crack at it. They're pretty much the same exact game, although Pong's ball and paddles are much smaller. Table Tennis was developed for the Magnavox Odyssey, a very early home video game console, and Atari saw money bags. However, Pong is simply a much better looking and better playing game than Table Tennis, and has had so much more commercial success as a result. I mean, really, if you were gonna start somewhere in the world of video game ripoffs, you might as well draw attention to the very first example of a game taking inspiration from another game, even if that game is something that's been around for much longer. I'm talking, of course, about real Table Tennis, but who plays real games anymore? I'm pretty sure all major football events are just Let's Plays of the latest Madden game anyway. At number 9, we have Saints Row. As much as we all love it, there's sort of a mutual understanding among various Saints Row players that, as fun as the game is, it's just kind of a ripoff of Grand Theft Auto. And this isn't necessarily a bad thing. GTA, I find, tends to take itself a little bit too seriously, while I prefer Saints Row's more comical and lighthearted tone. The series follows the misadventures of the gang the Third Street Saints, with the series flying off the rails further and further until the fourth entry into the series, whose story revolves around the main character, the president of the USA, helping fight an alien invasion. At this point, we probably can't really be calling Saints Row a ripoff of GTA, but the series started that way at least, and in my opinion, improved on it in quite a few ways. At number 8, we have Killer Instinct, which is a ripoff of Mortal Kombat. Now, hear me out here. Similar to many other beat-em-up fighting games of the early 90s, Killer Instinct is a game heavily inspired by titles such as Mortal Kombat and Street Fighter, with gameplay consisting of a side-on view of two characters with the intention of fighting one another until a finishing move is performed to end the battle. Similar aspects aside from this include the fatality sequences, now called the No Mercy moves, in which the player is given two moves to humiliate the opponent after they win, though certainly less gory than Mortal Kombat's editions. Though a fairly generic fighting game, Killer Instinct is an improvement from Mortal Kombat in terms of gameplay, introducing features such as combos, and changing the win requirements from a round-based system to a multiple life bar system, each player starting with two life bars that can be depleted over the course of a match. At number 7, we have Angry Birds. Believe it or not, Angry Birds wasn't an entirely original idea, despite being one of the largest mobile game brands in existence. I remember as a kid when I'd try to get around the bans the IT department would put on certain Flash game websites, and I'd often turn to sites like Miniclip or Cool Math Games. Crush the Castle, developed by Joey Betts and Chris Condon, was one of the games I remember playing back then, though I always assumed it was a ripoff of Angry Birds. I was completely wrong in this regard, as I found out that Angry Birds ended up coming out half a year later than its much more minimal counterpart. Anyone familiar with both of these games will instantly understand why it's on this list. The gameplay is basically the same, with the goal being to fire shots from a base on the left side of the map to destroy various obstacles on the right side of the screen. With Angry Birds' limited shots, quirky style, and generally more bright and appealing world, I think it can be classified as an improvement on the original Crush the Castle game, though Crush the Castle did provide a lot of the groundwork for what would eventually become the mobile game titan that it is. At number 6, we have Ms. Pac-Man. This is a weird one, as it started off as a mod for the original Pac-Man called Crazy Auto, which was developed by General Computer Corporation. But then the license to the mod was bought by Midway, and Ms. Pac-Man was born. Alright, so though technically a sequel to the original Pac-Man game, Ms. Pac-Man is a ripoff in the sense that it's basically the exact same game with some minor changes, such as the Pac-Man sprite having been changed to be wearing a bow now, and a few different maze levels. There's also the fact that the ghosts now move more randomly, rather than following a specific pattern that can be memorized and mastered, making the game more fair to the average player. Selling over 100,000 cabinets, Ms. Pac-Man earned the title of the highest-selling arcade game of 1981, seeing huge commercial success, though it's fairly obvious that it's close to being a clone of the original Pac-Man game. game. The minor improvements to the gameplay and design earned it a spot on this list, however, with the small changes making the game better in quite a few ways. At number 5, we have Project M, our first mod on the list, a community-made modification of Super Smash Bros. Brawl, developed by the, Project M development team. Great name. Project M's goal is to change the 2008 Wii title Brawl into having a playstyle more similar to its predecessors in the Smash Bros. Series. Fan objections to Brawl's slower-paced gameplay and changed physics, the mod brings back Dr. Mario, Mewtwo, and Roy. The project originally started as a desire to see Falco behave more similarly to his Melee incarnation, and the first demo build, launching as a complete redesign of Brawl, launched in 2011. While a modification is not an overt ripoff, Project M's goal is to change a pre-existing game to behave more like other pre-existing games, and while certainly a really cool project, counts as a ripoff to us. Considering the quality of Project M, it's only fitting that it would find a place on this list. It's great. At number 4, we have the iconic Guitar Hero franchise, a ripoff of the lesser-known Guitar Freaks game developed by Konami. Though the original Guitar Hero released to massive critical acclaim in 2005, Guitar Freaks released in arcades in 1999, being a rhythm game in which the player holds down a colored button and then moves the fret level whenever the note reaches what's called the fretting line. Currently, Guitar Freaks has seen well over a dozen different installments, with the newest title, Guitar Freaks XG3, coming out in 2012. The original came out just 1 year after Dance Dance Revolution was first seen in arcades, and so basically begins the popularization of the rhythm game genre. At number 3, we have Thug Pro, or Tony Hawk's Underground Pro, a community-made modification of Tony Hawk's Underground 2 that attempts to use the various Underground 2 mechanics in addition to levels from the Pro Skater series in order to create the dream Tony Hawk game. It's kind of up to you whether this one counts or not, seeing as it's not really a ripoff, but it is a mod made of older games, and it tends to be better than the originals, in my opinion. The mod was first released back in 2013 in beta mode, with multiplayer play being the main feature of the entire game. One journalist from Kotaku expressed optimism at the levels in the series being available for online play, particularly in the wake of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 5's less than great critical reception. If you have Tony Hawk's Underground 2 and would be interested in giving this mod a shot, check it out. Give it a Google. You might like it. At number 2, man, this is gonna be a controversial one. Number 2 is League of Legends, being a ripoff of Defense of the Ancients, the original Dota. It's the Warcraft 3 mod that would go on to receive a Valve-developed sequel, Dota 2. Both games were inspired by Aeon of Strife, which was a custom map for the original StarCraft, that would go on to create the MOBA subgenre of strategy games as we know them today. With League coming out in 2009, and the original Defense of the Ancients first seeing the light of day in 2003, there's really no doubt that League took heavy inspiration from the original mod in terms of playstyle and map design. Understand that we're not passing judgment on whether Dota 2 or League is the superior title, as that's a whole nother ballgame. But it's understandable that League, which came out before Dota 2, would be the better game when compared with a mod from way back when, especially with the community it's got together over the years, however toxic it may be. In the original Defense of the Ancients, two teams, the Sentinel and the Scourge, fight against one another in a large arena, with a heavy emphasis on teamwork in order to destroy a building entitled The Ancient. Stop me if that sounds familiar. And finally, at number 1, we have Minecraft. Now, okay, I know there's a lot of Minecraft ripoffs out there now, but did you know that Minecraft was actually an Infiniminer clone? I mean, Notch even admitted to this on multiple occasions on forum posts. Infiniminer is a procedurally generated block-building open-world sandbox, not too unlike Lego, set in a voxel world where the player is expected to mine using various in-world items. It sounds pretty familiar, right? The open source multiplayer game is developed by Zach Barth of Zachtronics that honestly just kind of feels a little bit underwhelming compared to Minecraft. Infiniminer was unfortunately discontinued, and the project's not really gonna see any work anytime soon. Zachtronics' page doesn't list much information about the game aside from stating that Infiniminer started the block building genre and is listed on the site for historical reasons. Infiniminer's gameplay was originally supposed to be competitive, involving teams competing against one another for points, though this was removed after Barth found the mining by itself to be the fun part of the game. Anyone who plays Minecraft will tell you that if the entire game was built around competitive gameplay, it wouldn't be nearly as interesting, so this was a move for the better. Infiniminer got discontinued a little while ago after an error in coding allowed the game to be decompiled. Some people made mods for Infiniminer using this vulnerability, with others making distinct forks of the game and so splitting the user base. Barth, later on IndieGames.com, would go to mention that he lost interest in the Infiniminer project soon after that, and with the massive success of Minecraft, he wasn't really going to be able to claim the OG throne again. I'm pretty sure everyone would just look at it and think it was another Minecraft clone, so I think he was kind of out of luck at that point. But overall, we do think Minecraft is the better game. It was well executed, and it's been developed over the course of a long, long time, and many new features have been added, so good on them. And there you have it, our list of the top 10 video game ripoffs that were better than the original. Do you agree? Did we miss something? Let us know in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe for more great videos from Arcade Cloud on Wednesdays, Saturdays, and Sundays. Take care, and game on.